get a thingy here. Where the fuck is it? Here it is. Hang on. There it is.
Recording this song was a really great experience. We got to go into Sweet Silence Studios in Copenhagen, Denmark with Flemming Rasmussen, who did Metallica, Ride the Lightning, Master of Puppets, and Justice for All. So I think it goes without saying, I mean, anybody that would know our band or know of us or listen to us, that Metallica, especially early Metallica, was just such a monumental influence. I mean, that was the band, that was the whole reason why I wanted to play music. And still to this day, you know, they inspire me every day.
Okay, he is human.
Turned out it worked out perfect because we were going on tour. And the first show was in Copenhagen, Denmark. And so we worked it out to where we went there a week early and went in the studio with him and just banged out these two songs. And it was an awesome experience.
He knew exactly how to, you know, translate the new generation with the old school. And that's kind of how what Night Demon is anyway. We're old school mixed with the modern.
Because I'm pushing that fucking quarter note.
I think that I really like
Can
that.
Can we hear this one more? I just want to, just from the top.
All right, let's do it.
The cool thing about being there at that time is that we also had our own equipment there, because, you know, doing something like that, you know, you're flying somewhere, you're scrambling, either you're renting stuff or, hey, what do you have in the studio, you know? And he didn't have much, I think, guitar wise so it's nice to have some of our own gear.
I had just finished a drum kit that I made, so I was able to record with my new drum kit that I had sent out, you know, that I brought over to Europe with us. So that was cool, being able to kind of break that in at his studio. We got some really good sounds.
I generally do not write about personal things. I've never been attached to my lyrics like, this is my, you know, this is my soul pouring out. And, you know, I've always been really open to having judgment from the other members of the band as far as lyrics go. I'm not one of those guys that takes myself so seriously when it comes to making music. And I've never tried to take any kind of personal or political stance on anything. But this song is a little bit different in the way that, you know, the topic of the song actually deals with suicide and taking your own life, which is a really heavy subject. I myself have struggled with thoughts of this many times in my life, and I've never really openly talked about it. It's a tough thing. I definitely think that us as men have a hard time being vulnerable and discussing these things with friends or just anybody that really cares about you. It's a hard thing sometimes to be able to discuss that without talking to somebody about it. You know, I don't know if I would be here today. So to be able to kind of tell a story or to be able to put that into words where somebody else that's going through this can relate to, I think that was a really important thing for us as a band to do.
When Jarvis told me the idea for the lyrics, I was a little hesitant at first, like, well, we don't really get into that kind of stuff, but you know what? Maybe we should now, you know?
Open the lens. Oh, hello.
It's open, Doc. Yeah. Are we going?
Yeah. We're going.
Shit. Oh, shit. I'm falling. Official engineering.
That's right.
The B-side of the Kill the Pain single is a cover by Cirith Ungol, the song 100 Miles Per Hour. It didn't actually end up on an album until the late 80s. It was on the One Foot in Hell album. It was re-recorded. But it's not a song that's widely popular, and it's not a song that the band ever plays live. And we always heard the song and thought, man, we could really do a great job covering this song.
Yeah, it was never one of my favorite songs, but it is now. I don't even remember what album it's on.
I'm in 100 miles an hour!
Per hour.
Okay. You know, those guys are our brothers, and we work with them, we record them, we travel with them, we play shows with them all the time. They're the Venturas, kind of like, you know, the hometown metal band that, you know, there's no other bands I could think of from this town that have been around that long and made that many records and that people love all over the world.
Well, I mean, it's one of our old songs, and you know, Jarvis told me they wanted to do a remake of it, which was kind of odd because it's, you know, well, not really, it's kind of a more of a faster, you know, thrashy kind of song, so it wasn't surprising he wanted to do that. But him to do a remake of one of our songs is like an honor for them to do it, you know, because they've done, you know, stuff, the Scorpion songs, Thin Lizzy songs, and things like that. So it was really kind of cool that they wanted to pick one of ours.
Oh, bucket lists. I never thought, you know, oh yeah, it'd be cool to do that, you know, with him. I never thought it actually ever happened, you know, but we're in a day and an age now where you can, it's not hard to reach out to people that you think are out of reach anymore, you know?
It's just one of those moments that you think, you know, when you're in it, you're so engaged in what's happening that it's hard to take a step back and until later, after the fact, when you come back and realize, like, man, did that just really happen? Or did we just, you know, were we just a part of, did we just make our own history as a band with combining something historical that we love, something that inspired us? It kind of comes together as one. Like we were able to use some of the personnel and the equipment and the spirit, and we had the total vibe that we felt like what it must have been like for those guys to be recording those records back when. We love.